No wedding? After Carly Mata-harried her way into Tony's heart and dragged him all the way up to the altar, what happened? Did he get a reprieve from the governor?
More like from Mother Nature. They were about to get married when Carly collapsed. Contractions, she said, bad enough to make her think it was the real thing. So the wedding is on hold and Carly is on her back at GH.
What is she trying to pull?
Oh, no, this kind of thing is not that easy to fake.
Hey, if there's a way to fake it, if there's a way to avoid the truth, Carly will find it.
Well, you know, she has been honest about two things in her life. She wants Tony and she wants this baby. And just imagine in one day she came this close to gaining one and losing the other.
What am I hearing? Sympathy for the she-devil?
I don't know what you call it. Something happened today that made me see Carly in a very different way than I've ever seen her before. Well, AJ told me that Carly had been brought in. I found myself covering the fourth floor, and who do I find behind door number one but the next Mrs. Jones?
Oh, couldn't you have handed her off to somebody else?
Well, I suppose I could have, but I don't want to spend the rest of my life dodging her, so I actually found myself standing in her doorway. But Luke, she seemed to be talking to someone, but there was nobody in the room. And then I realized she was talking to her baby. She was saying, you know, what a great dad she thought Tony was going to be, and how she wanted her baby to have a wonderful life. And all of a sudden, the strangest thing happened, you know. I couldn't help it. I just started feeling compassion for this woman who destroyed my life. Because she reminded me of myself. When I was pregnant, I was unmarried. And I was wondering if there was ever going to be a place in the world for the child I was carrying.
How long did you stand in the doorway?
I don't know. It wasn't very long. I went inside to talk to her. And I actually expected her to be her angry, belligerent self, but she wasn't. She very simply asked me how I was able to give up my baby.
Barbara, you did the best thing for that child at the time. Nobody has a right to question that choice now or to judge you 20 years later.
But she wasn't judging me. And I wasn't angry. It was so confusing. And now, I'm curious.